Wells Fargo, the largest auto lender in the United States with about $1.92 trillion in assets, actually has an intriguing story behind its start. But what turned out to be devastating for the company, which shook the empire, was the scandal dated back in 2012, one that seems to have become a permanent part of their reputation, with no sign of letting go anytime soon. William Fargo and Henry Wells dreamt of heights that were way out of an ordinary person's league back in the 19th century. Their strong sense of determination paved the way for a brand worth trillions of dollars today. Let's get a closer look at this brand's journey. William George Fargo was born into the farming family of William C. and Tracy Strong Fargo on May 20, 1818, Pompeii, New York, as the eldest of 12 children. In the summers, he worked on his father's farm, and in the winters, he went to school. When he turned 13, he was hired to carry mail on a 43-mile route around his hometown of Pompeii, New York, an experience that left a lasting impact on his life. At the beginning of his career, William had started making investments, including several railroad companies, thus opening the door to meet the Northern Pacific Railroad. His association with railroads greatly impacted several cities, including Fargo, North Dakota, which bears his namesake. He had made investments in several railroad towns. He pursued various jobs as a young adult until he married Anna H., a local girl, in 1840. They went on to have 8 children together, though only 3 of them could complete their education. Fast forward a few years, and in 1845, William became the first freight agent at Auburn for the Auburn and Syracuse Railroad. His excellent performance led Henry Wells to hire him as a messenger to extend his express service to Cleveland, Chicago, and other points in the Midwest. William used this opportunity to climb aboard the stagecoach and steamboat to deliver packages, paper, and money, including a regular 8-day trip from Buffalo to Detroit. He used that experience to set up a business under his name later and hire his messengers. In 1850, Henry, William, and the other messengers under them combined their various companies under the name American Express Company, resulting in a vast network of messengers and offices for customers all along the East Coast and into the Midwest. At the same time, news of gold being discovered in California sparked one of the most significant migrations in American history, with people flocking to the state searching for their riches. Reliable coast-to-coast connectivity, freight transportation, and payment services were needed for the first time. After seeing the needs during this period, William and Henry approached the American Express Board of Directors and suggested expanding to meet the needs of their Pacific Coast customers. Since most of the board of directors declined, they agreed to form their firm, Wells Fargo & Co. Butterfield, the largest stockholder in American Express, blocked American Express from participating in the California Gold Rush, which was one of the primary reasons Wells Fargo & Co. came into being, only to handle the Pacific Coast and ultimately all business in the Far West. Through interlocking express company directorships, William took a particular interest in transcontinental service. Butterfield's Overland Mail Company was a success from its beginning in 1858, but Wells Fargo and American Express fought for control of its board. Butterfield lost. At a directors' meeting in 1860, Henry mentioned, "All of the profanity that one head could hold and one tongue could utter was used to express his friendship towards Fargo and me." This was the beginning of a business that grew to be a trillion-dollar industry over the years. Henry and William served on the board of directors after founding the company. They were often associated with Wells Fargo when they were introduced at events or reported in the press. Besides this, William also served twice as mayor of Buffalo during the Civil War. At his inauguration in 1862, he vowed, "In this hour of national peril and trial, when every man feels or should feel the necessity of lending his whole strength to the government, it is no easy task to turn to the detail of municipal affairs, and yet it was never more important that our local governments should be properly administered." While working on running the city smoothly, he also contributed to the war effort. He helped Union forces prevent a Confederate plot to invade Buffalo and other Lake Erie cities by paying for care packages to be sent to Buffalo soldiers, providing a local regiment with a regimental flag. Meanwhile, William ran American Express, made a fortune, and designed a two-block mansion in Buffalo with the help of his brother James. Outside of New York City, the Fargo Mansion was the most elaborate and expensive private mansion in the state. It was built for $600,000, which is about $15 million today. He left his heirs $20 million and a house that was so costly to maintain that it ultimately was demolished. He also left his autocratic brother in charge of the business when he died in 1881. William George Fargo was a pioneer expressman who helped found the modern-day financial firms of the American Express Company and Wells Fargo, and changed how money is handled forever. Today, Wells Fargo continues to follow in its founder's footsteps, adapting to the demands of a changing environment and searching out new ways to assist its customers in achieving financial success. If you enjoyed this video, consider hitting the like and subscribe buttons. It does wonders for the YouTube algorithm, so more people can see our videos and so that you can be notified when we launch our next video. We try and put out at least one new one per week, and as you can imagine, the research and editing alone of these type of videos takes us close to 18 hours. So we would really appreciate it if you could also check out our Patreon. For just $1 a month, you can support our work. We produce over 12 videos per month, so that is literally 8 cents per video. Thank you so much, and we'll see you at our next unmasking.